Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Enhanced Edition, Blind. Now heading for Wyrm's Crossing.
All right.
I believe it's called this.
You have been waylaid by enemies and must defend yourself.
6 hours so far. We got bandits. We'll collect all the crap later. Yeah, you got kicked in the head till you were dead.
Go for the ice pool! Go for the ice!
That's it. Oh, I couldn't make out what that was. He was in the middle of an animation.
Your life shall be mine.
You're doomed, mister. Agni Manny necklace. Bluestone necklace. Ripping the scalps off them. Cool.
Why me?
Okay. Almost there.
Sheep haven't been putting out lately.
What? Sheep haven't been putting out lately? Seriously? Hey, who are you? We're adventurers. Never met adventurers before. Well, if you're a bunch of heroes, maybe you could find out who's been dumping all their waste in the lakes around here. You could find out who's at fault. Maybe put a stop to it. Permanent-like.
Why me?
You cannot initiate dialogue. Farmer appears busy. Alright. Nice new theme. Ooh, I like it. Waste in the lakes. Okay, so that's the great bridge that leads across to Baldur's Gate, at least eventually. Let's explore this side of the land first, if we can. Oh, not much, that's for sure. There's anything else around here? Any wildlife or monsters to kill? Or just farmers who talk about their sheep not putting out? Can't get over there. Oh, who's this? Tenya. Let's go talk to Tenya.
Stop! You are trespassing on my land home!
None has come this way armed as you are. It was those horrible fishermen that hired you, wasn't it? Speak! This is a very spirited child, but a child nonetheless, Dinahir says. I trust that thou hast concluded rightly who is in the wrong here. They did send me, but I wish only to know what is going on. What goes on is none of your business. Leave now, lest you earn the same fate that they have.
Emberleaf guides my way.
You return? I warn you once again to leave my home. If you do not, I must assume you are allied with my enemies. As cowardly as they are treacherous, hiring others to do what they could not. Tonight I shall put an end to all this. The seas cry for vengeance. Okay, we're under attack. I wonder if this really is a child or someone under an illusion. Well, we must defend ourselves. Oh my. Oh, she's commanding Kagan. No one commands our Kagan and gets away with it. Looks like she failed at it. Kagan saved us a spell. He rolled well on that one. 20. Why do you do this? Don't you know what they've done? Sooner and the others... Oh, Sonner. Sonner, they're the ones from the farmland to the south. With that lake. Sonner and the others, they are the evil ones. They killed my mother, and now you help them? She only did her duty, collecting the offerings from those who would use the sea. They stole her elemental summoning bowl and tortured her for the words that make it work. Now they all misuse a gift from Umberlee to pillage the seas, and my mother's spirit can't rest until it is returned. I have more power than mother had. Umberlee gave me her anger, but I can't find the bowl. All I can do is hurt them until I give it back or die. But I'm so tired. I don't have mother's will, and the goddess is so demanding. Help me, please. Shush, child. I shall help as best I can. Oh, thank you. The Sea Queen may yet be satisfied with the return of the bowl, but one way or another, Sonner's group must no longer profit at her expense. Probably being hidden in a shrine to another god. I don't know where the shrine is and couldn't go near even if I did, but Sonner may tell you if you ask him with a blade. Go now, for Umberlee is seldom patient and you are not yet on her good side. Don't stop attacking her.
Sure.
The priestess I was sent to kill is no more than a child of perhaps 12 years. She says the fisherman who hired me killed her mother. I shall go confront them on her behalf. You return. I trust you bear good news. I have not yet retrieved the bowl or dealt with Sonner. The Bitch Queen is not called so because of her patient nature. Quicken your step. I returned to Tenya without having carried out her wishes. She no longer seems quite the meek child. I feel it's best not to keep her waiting, really. Well, I'm gonna... I really want to check out her house. I'm gonna look around back here first. There's an Ankh-Egg, okay. We'll deal with that.
Go for the ice, Boo! Go for the ice! Rusk!
Go pester someone else.
Is that called?
What?
Forgot about these on kegs. They're a lot easier to deal with now.
All right.
Oh, who's this? Nestor's dagger? Who's Nestor? The typical dagger is just telling us about a dagger. Know anything about Nestor's dagger? Oh, that egg. Yeah, the mage to get it might be still on his way to Baldur's Gate. So he might not be in Baldur's Gate. I guess we'll hold on to it. I don't know who Nestor is. I can't get back there. I'm not crossing the bridge yet. We're going to return to the fisherman. Let me just see what's over here. If anything. Fog of war as much as possible. I know I'm crazy with that. Alright. We're going now, kid. Promise. At least we're heading that way. Darkness falls. Very spooky all of a sudden, let's say. All right, let's go deal with these fishermen. They are here. 4 hours. We got an enemy. Ah, oh, yeah.
Go for the ice!
Give us
go for
victory.
The ice!
Here comes a mage. I beg your pardon? Ah, travelers, on your way to Baldur's Gate as well? You haven't been any chance seen a delivery man on your way? I expected his arrival over 2 weeks ago, but he did not show up. Now I am on my way home again. But wait a minute. What do I see there? That is, you have it. That egg. That stone-like egg you have there. Where do you have it from, pray tell? How the hell would you know we have it? We're not, like, holding it in our hands as we attack this thing. Dig deep inside someone's pack. I could give it to you, but that makes 500 gold for the transport. Ah, no, it is... You were carrying it wrongly. It is ruined. You let it get hot, didn't you? Don't say anything. It is useless. The whole travel, all for nothing. I needed it preserved. Now it got warm. Ah, whatever. I couldn't take it even if I wanted to. Way too dangerous now. I lost interest in this. You fix it. Just take that thing away, far away from me. It is your responsibility now. Aw, oh, damn. One advice, stranger. Take that thing to a magically experienced person who knows how to use it, or you will have a nasty surprise in a week or two. We met the mage that was supposed to get the egg stone. He said some weird things about a nasty surprise I would get, but I won't show the egg to a powerful mage. Well, we already know from Thalantir that it's a... Well, unless he's wrong, or lying, it's a wraith spider in there. I can't carry another one of these. Or can I? Apparently I can. is the egg that's warm. Oh well, no one wants this thing because it's warm.
Sure.
Hopefully somebody in Baldur's Gate will be able to help us out. Ah, there's a fisherman all the way over here. Oh, here's Gerd. Is she the one who was gonna... telling us about killing the arm cakes?
Me?
I forget. Good work, and I trust that you stuck to the quota. Here's 75 gold pieces. Go find yourself a room in the city and rest up. You've earned it. Cool. Arm cakes are tough to kill, but Gerd's reward of 75 gold pieces is welcome. Never mind, we have... how much? Over 48,000 gold pieces.
I need an ale.
You can buy a lot of ale with that money. I am not going back in this nest. You guys must not be happy with it so close to their house. Here are these guys. Tillman. Jebedo. Sonner is the one we want. See if these guys have anything to say. They'll probably respond as one anyway. Have you done it? Have you killed the bitch? Tillman says. The priestess had much to say about the group of you. She knows we sent you? Damn it. She'll kill us all for... Sonner says, hold your tongue, Tillman. Now I warned you she was treacherous. You've gone and believed her lies, haven't you? What did she say? That we stole some bowl or something? Seems a pretty shallow excuse to kill us over, doesn't it? Now, as I said before, we are but poor fishermen, but what if we toss in another, 100 gold? Will that change your mind? The child has said that you killed her mother and have been taking far too much from the seas. I don't like being used, Sonner. It makes me angry. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry. Tillman says, well, that's it, eh? The jig's up, isn't it? Jebedo says, that bitch priestess was taking tribute from us for years. The price just kept climbing, and you can't sail without appeasing Umberly. The cleric of Talos and Baldur's Gate said... Sonner says, suffice to say we made other arrangements for our safe passage at sea. Part of that deal was a little payback as well. So you see, we are all pawns within the friendly rivalries of the gods. You'd best tread carefully, lest you step on some pretty powerful toes. Give me the bowl, Sonner. I'll not ask so nicely a second time. I suppose I have little choice, then. I've had it on me the entire time. We felt it was safest that way. Take it, but know that the Storm Lord knows who it is that opposes him. You've got what you came for. Now get out of here. I should stay well away from any Talos shrine if I were you. Vengeful things, these gods. Bowl of Water Elemental Control. The fishermen seek the guidance of the god Talos. Surely this lends extra weight to Tenya's story, as Talos is a deity of mindless destruction. The child said take priority in this matter. I have retrieved the bowl sought by the Sea Queen. Though at the cost of displeasing the followers of Talos, even so, it will certainly be worth the joy I bring to that troubled child.
Damn forest! Always reminds me of pansy elves.
Sonner says, back, I see. He doesn't realize that the conversation we just had. Your name won't mean much if you go around breaking deals. So be it. We'll deal with the child ourselves. What? Oh. Now they're going to attack us? Talos, the god of destruction, is behind the actions of the fishermen. Umberly is behind the young priestess Tenya. I cannot see a way to avoid displeasing one, and I do not truly wish the favor of the other. I will have nothing more to do with any of them. Alright, they're going to attack us now. Okay.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Oh, I got a magical flail.
Tempest, give us victory!
Go for the ice, Boo! Go for the ice! Rusk!
Oh, there's a bandit over here, too. Enchantus?
Your life shall be mine.
Oh, there's quite a few.
Tempest, give us victory!
For right!
Give us victory!
For right!
Okay, it takes care of that. Oh, there it is. The bowl of water elemental control. Here we got a lot of arrows. Let's check this thing out. This magical bowl holds great power in that it grants the owner a certain degree of control over magical creatures known as water elementals. As is the case with all elemental forces, this control can be turned towards either good or evil, law or chaos. One would therefore be well advised to use discretion when dealing with any such creatures. Well, we can't use it. At least it doesn't appear we can. But I'll be returning it, nonetheless.
All right.
We can just leave this way. Well, you talk to them again, and you could end up killing them.
Sure.
Probably gonna be getting tired soon. Wonder if you could rest out here. Maybe you can rest in this child's house. Certainly want to take a look around in there anyway. You know me.
Umberly guides my way.
Well, that's what she says. You return. I trust you bear good news. Here is the bowl that was taken from your mother. Perhaps now she will rest. Umberly is mother now, and she is well pleased. She will deal with Sarner's group in time, and Talos will no doubt abandon them for their failure. Mother did. If they are wise, they will never set sail again, for the sea will take their worthless lives. I have no reward for you, but the Sea Queen remembers those that serve her well. You will be paid in time. I've been promised a future reward for my role in vanquishing the fishermen aligned with Talos. Strange, though, I do not feel as though I have helped the child, so much as I have been the pawn of a spiteful god. Deities are not to be trifled with. They trifle back. Alright, she's gone. Now we can explore this home. Ooh.
Sure.
Let's make sure nobody's actually at home. Well, this might anger the god, but what are you gonna do?
Sure.
Should I be searching for traps? I guess so.
Alright, alright.
Alright, 26 gold. Some darts for Minsk.
Swinky wheel gets the kick.
Alright, alright.
A jade ring and a skydrop gem.
Such menial tasks.
I know. Picking up priceless jewels and rings. It's just so dreadfully boring.
Alright. Alright.
All right, well, that takes care of that tail. Now we can cross the bridge. I'm not tired yet, right? It's been quite a journey. Wyrm's crossing, here you go. Just going to the sides like this to clear the fog of war whenever possible. Or as much as possible. Stuff like that. Well, there's not much up here so far. More bridge.
I serve the flaming fist.
Oh no, not the flaming fist again. The entrance tax is 6 gold pieces for each party of travelers. Please announce your point of origin. The mystical land of frolicking naked nymphs for every desire is granted by bald, blubbering bugbears. Baragost, you'll have to wait here. My commander wishes to have a word with you.
Citizens, please step forward.
For each party, I thought you meant party members. Huh. First off, let me introduce myself. I'm Scar, second in command of the Flaming Fist. Though it is not necessary for you to reveal your names, please answer me this. Are you the group that was involved in the trouble at the Nashkel Mines? Yes, that was us. Well, I say you have made quite the commotion up here in Baldur's Gate. I can't really put my finger on a single source, but there have been many strange happenings going on within the city. It's getting harder and harder for me to put trust in someone. I need outsiders to do some investigations, people with no connections to anyone within the city. Would you be interested in working for me in such a capacity? If it pays well, sure. All right, then. What I'm about to tell you must be held in the strictest confidence. Do you understand? I need you to begin an investigation of the Seven Suns trading Coster. The Seven Suns leadership has been acting strangely of late. They've been selling off valuable assets and neglecting many of their more profitable trading ventures. Considering the importance that the trading Coster holds over the economy of the city, the Grand Dukes are noticeably upset. I've gone to talk to the Coster's head, Jasso. He rudely rebuffed me, telling me to mind my own business. I've known Jasso for many years, and this isn't his usual behavior. I can't start up an official investigation, as there is no real reason for doing so. That's why I need you. So we trust this scar. Who knows? He might be part of it. Or the flaming fist entirely might be part of it. Ah, why not? We're ready to go for it. We're ready to go for it, but there's something you need to know first. We think that the Iron Throne may be behind recent events along the coast. At the mines in Nashkel and in Cloakwood, we've learned much about the goals and methods of the Iron Throne, and it doesn't bode well for the future of this region. Wow, that sheds new light on things. There's nothing I can really do about it now, but I'll make sure to look into it. I want you to break into the Seven Suns compound and find out what's wrong. Use stealth in your investigations. I don't want this operation to cause too much fuss. The most important person to watch for is Jasso. Once you've found out as much as possible, report back to me at the Flaming Fist compound. I'll pay you 2,000 gold for this favor. Okay, so where is the Seven Suns compound and where is the Flaming Fist compound? The estate is located on the southwest side of town. Well, there you go. I wish all of you the best of luck. Remember, once you're done at the Seven Suns estate, it is imperative that you meet me at the Flaming Fist barracks, which are just west of the Seven Suns. Okay. Southwest side. And they're west of that. Scar has hired us to investigate strange goings-on in the Seven Suns compound in the southwest section of the city. Once we have completed our investigation, we ought to report to him at the Flaming Fist barracks, which are located just west of the Seven Suns building. Indeed. Oh! I want a word with you. Okay. Kagan says, for a big'un, that Baldur must have had some sense. If he didn't hire dwarves for this here stonework, I'm a kobold's granny. Let's hope we didn't damage things by spilling the beans to him. I'm just gonna have to hope he's on the up and up. Quail? We got Dan Quail over here. Who are these? A Dread Wolf. Emmanuel Silver Sword. And a wolf. Okay. Hail, a quail!
Walking alone in the Coastway Road. How smart is this?
Hey ho, fellow travelers. You look to be wanderers of the adventuring sort. Tell me, what direction calls you? I am proceeding in a northerly direction this day. Ah, my loutish friends, that is my direction too. Fate has crossed our paths, and we could all benefit by traveling together. It will be the classic pairing of you, the stalwart adventurers, and I, the intelligent one. How could you refuse? We don't have any room, so how can I refuse? Take thou a hike. I should have guessed by your knuckle-dragging gait and minuscule nose. You're a complete and utter moron, aren't you? I've met a man named Quail near Baldur's Gate who requested he be allowed to join my party. It was the bum's rush I gave him, as he seemed a touch too smarmy for my liking. And because we, you know, our adventuring party was, full. Oh yeah, and a farmer who we met in the Wood of Sharp Teeth has told us that someone has been dumping waste in the forest. Tales of my actions are spreading, though I'm not sure I like the term mercenaries. South of Candlekeep is a treasure cove. Wonder if that's where we just were, Shipwreck Crossing or not. Alright, let's talk to... Oh my god, quite a cavalry of wolves here. A winter wolf, a dire wolf, a vampiric wolf, a dread wolf, and a wolf. Emmanuel Silversword.
Fools to cross my path.
Snowball, here. Swiftclaw, excuse you. Dread, leave the dwarf alone. Babe, stay. You're a good girl. Fang, stop drooling over all over this good lord. She is not our prey. Oh, okay then.
All right.
So you don't want to talk to us. You just want to talk to your wolves. That's fine. I don't know what you're doing with all of them, but whatever. See what else is here, if anything. Hugging the coast here. Okay, we've reached the south end. Don't see any much out here. Wolves and friends. Chickens. Alright, chickens. Chicken licking. Hello, chickens. Lightning again. So there's Wyrm's Crossing. As much as I could uncover, anyway. I'm wondering if we can go to this other area. North of here somewhere? No, we can't. Not yet, anyway. All got speared. Well, they've done quite a lot. I'm not sure if I'm entering Baldur's Gate. Yeah, I guess we have to. There's not really... We can't get to the other areas. So I guess, yeah, next episode, Baldur's Gate. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.